Hi fellows, this is Jack Treiser and in this video I like to talk about stereo bass, why it's important and how to achieve it properly. First of all, let's give it a listen. Bass track with the spread. Okay, let's solo the bass track and let the spread channel be engaged for now. Spread channel muted. Okay, first of all, when you think about bass, you might wonder, is he crazy? Why would he do a bass that's stereo? It's true that you want to aim for a mono bass in the lower frequencies, but in this case, I decided that I want the bass to be huge in the mix and very prominent. So what I made is this. I made another return channel. It's called bus spread for obvious reasons, and then I've got an EQ8. Before that, I'm surely sending 100% of the dry mono bass signal, in this case my Moog bass with a little bit of source audio Ventris. It's a huge reverb, check this out if you can. I'm sending it to that return channel. And I'm cutting off the low frequencies to about 240 hertz. And then basically it's just as simple as making use of the Haas effect. So you want to get a simple delay, switch it to time on both channels, left and right, and then give it a little bit of delay. So your perception of that signal is wider than just exactly from the middle. So let's hear this in solo. I hope this works. Okay, and now with the bass signal. And then you basically just add it to the mix. To a certain degree, in my case, I decided 0 decibels are quite fine, and therefore you've got a nice balance. You've got your mono bass, but also for the upper frequencies, you achieve a nice stereo image. So the bass feels more prominent and a little bit like resonating or bigger than just mono, while having a good mono compatibility because your low frequencies are, even after that treatment, in mono. I hope you liked this video. If yes, give me a thumbs up and subscribe. I'll do more of this type of content in the future. Bye bye.